Welcome. We're live here from the Daytona Short Track, built on the backstretch specifically for this event. It is the Bait Clash. 18 drivers here will take on this tough track, all in which are full-time running for points this season in the Bait. And it should be a fun one. The Cup cars just got done from Springfield. Brian Leon had to fly his ass down here immediately after to get here on time, because, you know, he ran that race. So it should be a fun one. These trucks, we haven't seen them yet on track other than, you know, that one race, so it should be fun. Let's get into it. Trucks are rolling off. That is where obviously the start finish line is. That is against the backstretch wall. The lake is right behind that wall. Now we're going on to the actual Daytona backstretch with the stands. C Packet starting on pole, followed by Kylie Grider, Kyler Sustry, Ian Stiles, and Caden Bishop rounding out the top five. As they're coming around to turns three and four, about to take the green flag. C Packet, he should get a pretty good jump here based on the fact that he's on that inside lane. Green flag is in the air. We haven't seen much testing here, so I'm going to be curious to see whether there's a lot of cautions or if it's just some straight up good racing. They're three wide in the back already. C Packet still leading. Kyler Sustry diving it on his teammate, Kylie Grider. They're still three wide in the back. Oh, and someone's around. Looks like Ian Stiles. The caution is out. Man, that really sucks for him. He was starting up front. He was running pretty good, too. Seemed to have a fast car during practice. He is automatically back to the back, as well as Tyler Goh. Tough break for them. Tyler Goh driving the one of Minion in the field. For Aurora Knights, that team needs money to succeed. They're a small team. They just started out. Team owner got a couple wins last season in the NABART, but this is not a good way to start your season. I don't think anyone's going to pit here. It's really pointless. I don't think we'll see any pit stops at all, actually, now that I think about it. We're going to go ahead and we're going to take a look at our instant replay. It looks like the 03 just sends it in and just takes him out. I don't know if that was intentional or if it was an accident. I'm sure the 17 is not happy nonetheless, though. We're going to go on board with the 03. All over the back bumper, tries to get to the inside. Oh, the 17 17 looked like it was spinning out from mid-turn. I don't know if that was because the 03 was taking air off of it, or if the 03 was actually in making contact. I don't know. But we're back. The cars are still making caution laps. C. Packett will be trying to do the sweep. Obviously not in this race, but he is running the Daytona 500 in the 20 for Ghost Motorsports due to Simon Black's suspension. So he will try and be winning the truck race at Daytona and the cup race, which I think would be pretty cool. Kylie Greider, she ran two seasons in the NABAR, got a win at Willow Springs due to a DNQ from Tanner Campos. And last season, driving full-time for Tao, just did not have a good season. Lost her charter midway through the season. And just got, I don't know if I'd say she got demoted. It was like a mutual agreement to go down to the bay to try and develop some more. Kyler Susterine, third, is an all-around brand-new driver, rookie, driving for Tao Racing. Got that great opportunity due to his good runs in late models. So we'll see how he does. Anyways, the pace truck's off. C. Packett is going to lead them back to the green. Susterine dives in on Greider immediately. And he's in a clear. What a move. And here comes Brian Leon on Kylie Greider. Like I said, Brian Leon might be a little jet lagged. Just flew down here from Springfield. Had to get here immediately as he ran in both the clashes. Oh, something's in the wall back there. Doesn't look like major damage, so we'll continue going. Here comes Kylie back on Susterine. Brian Leon gets sent way wide, almost up into the wall. And C. Packett loves to see this as he is running away, but Susterine gains a lot in that turn. They're still battling three wide for fourth place, going at it, beating and banging. Can Susterine develop a run? Oh, Bishop and Leon. We're making contact everywhere. C. Packett loves to see this. He is driving a four. The manufacturer battle is something I'm really interested in this series. Is there is a lot of Fords, a little bit of Chevys, a little bit of Dodges, and like no Toyotas and Minions. It's kind of interesting to see. Tyler Goh is on pit road. Something must be wrong with that truck after the contact. That is not good for that young driver. And that team in general. Anthony Sasso. Here comes Ian Stiles trying to make a move on him. Anthony's an all-around new driver too. Seems to be good friends with two-time champion Tyler King. And Tyler gave him the stamp of approval to be a good driver, you know. They used to race together a lot back in the good old days before Tyler became a star. And he got picked up by Marinelli Merrill. So that's how it happened. And we'll see how he does this rookie season. Tyler goes back on track. Lap traffic will play a factor into this. Unless CPAC is just that slow. We'll see. It should be interesting. CPAC is one of my favorite stories in this series. He, out of nowhere, just came up, drove for a championship-contending team as their second car. And he went out there. At first, he was struggling, you know, to get used to it. But then after that, the last few races of the season, running top five, top two, leading laps. He even got to battle his hero, Tyler King, for a championship. I mean, he wouldn't win the championship, but Tyler was, and he got to race him for the win. Really cool story there in that group. And he's down in the bait trying to hone his skills a little bit more. He's going to go back up in the Cup Series. He's going to kick some ass. Kyler Susterine, though, is still working on him. The gap is staying pretty much the exact same. We're 15 laps through this race. Brian Leon making another move on Caden Bishop. These two still battling. Oh, and Bishop goes wide. Terrible corner entry. Got a little loose, it looks like, going in. But he's going to get a huge run off the turn. Side by side still. This is crazy. Oh, Leon tried to clear him, but he couldn't. Bishop's still there on the outside. Can Leon clear him this time? No, he can't. Really good battle back here. Ian Styles behind him. CPAC, it's still running away with it. Ian Styles working his way back through the field fast. He's gained tons of spots. Got around Dylan Jones, Anthony Sasso, Tyron Rose. Bishop puts the crossover on Leon, and now he is on the inside, but he cannot get a run off corner exit. All this battling should help Ian Styles catch, but the top three are running away. We're now on lap 20 of 45. The laps are winding down quite quickly. CPAC, it loves to see this. There's also some lap traffic on the horizon. CPAC, obviously sponsored by Kmart, loyal sponsor. You know, Kmart's been, like, really loyal to him. I think that's a really good decision on their part, because he should put him in victory lane a couple times this season. We'll see, though. You never know. One of them could be tonight. Don't forget, there could always be a caution, which will shake things up. You know, there was a caution like lap 2. Ian Styles has worked his way back pretty good from that, actually. Already in the top 7. If I were CPAC, I would start experimenting with different lines to try and save tires with my lead. And then just go back to the one I was running before if I start to lose my lead. Brian Leon goes way wide in that turn. Caden Bishop to the inside. Cannot get a run, though. Down the front straightaway. Or I guess the back straightaway. I don't know what you would call it. It's the front straightaway on the back straightaway. It's complicated. Fred Jones, Anthony Ryder back in the back. Fred Jones full-time in this series for this season. Well-known super speedway racer. We'll see how he does. There's the lap traffic right ahead of him. And they're battling side-by-side ahead of him, too. Brian Leon dives in big time in that turn. He's not going to be able to get a good run off, though. This 69 truck for this team is going to be really interesting this season because they also have a second truck, which is the 96 truck, fielding James Amaki and Jared Holmes for the truck schedule. So that is going to be cool. We'll see how they mentor CPAC at almost. And if they could do better than him in that truck, having less experience. I say that, but Jared Holmes won the truck race that we did last season. So, you know. Here comes CPAC, though. He sees Fred Jones and Anthony Ryder ahead of him. Anthony Ryder at GMC, one of the only ones in the field. Fred Jones is the other one, so they're not having a good day. Trying to get into the sport a little bit more. Trying to experiment with teams who might not have manufacturers already, like Allen Motors, who is funded by mainly Buick, which don't have a truck. Oh, CPAC gets around Fred Jones on the inside. Flawlessly, nice. Get around Anthony Ryder. He's going to go to the outside. Oh, he's in the back bumper. Big contact there. Now he's stuck on the outside. Fred Jones dives it in. He got into the back bumper of Anthony Ryder hard, trying to send him through that corner. Now he's stuck. He's getting cleared by Anthony Ryder. CPAC does not want to deal with this. Here comes Kyler Sestri. CPAC are trying to work his way around the outside. Here comes Kyler. Will Kyler go to the outside? If I were Kyler, I would stay on the inside. Oh, there he goes, to the inside. Can he get to the door of C-Packet? Oh, no corner exit. C-Packet into the back of the 25 hard, trying to tell him to move out of the way. I am the leader, but they are not listening, as he should clear Anthony Ryder there. Oh, Kyler Sestri punts Anthony Ryder way up the track. Into the wall. Here comes Kylie Grider. What a move by Kyler Sestri. He told him to move out the way. These lap cars are blocking their hearts out for no reason. To be fair, it is not a big track, though. Grider up to second now. Can she catch C-Packet? The laps are winding down fast. C-Packet has more lap traffic ahead. That is Quinn Yeager and Chris Black. Here comes C-Packet. Will he go to the inside or the outside of Quinn? Quinn might try and block. Quinn's a stubborn driver. C-Packet contact. Whoa. Here comes Grider. Looks like C-Packet will get to the inside of Yeager. But he won't clear him. Quinn is hanging on in that outside lane. Here comes Grider to the inside of Quinn. She sure as heck won't clear him. But C-Packet still has to get around Chris Black. Here comes Kylie diving it into the inside of C-Packet. No corner exit speed. She's going to have to make a move. C-Packet. Oh, he sends it in wide. Grider to the inside. Side by side for the lead. C-Packet. Now he gets to the inside of Chris Black. Oh, Grider goes wide that turn. Bad turn for Grider. Here comes Kyler Sestri. Kylie still holds the position, though. Oh, no. She's stuck in the back of Chris Black. Oh. Quinn's in the wall behind him. Here comes Kylie to the inside of Chris Black. C-Packet has cleared all the lap traffic, though. He just has to hit his marks. Kylie Grider right behind him, though. You never know. She could be faster. She's been stuck behind Sestri this whole race. We haven't really been able to see her true speed. C-Packet running these turns perfectly, hitting his marks. Grider's still there, though. She might be gaining. Oh, she lost a little bit off that. But it looks like she was gaining for a second. Leon to the inside of Jason Elliott. Tau Racing having a really good day, as they have three trucks in the top five. Nobody takes home cash this race besides the winner, though. And the winner will take home $1 million check, just as much as the Cup Clash. Hard battling back in the pack, as always. Ian Stiles still trying to get around Caden Bishop. Has been struggling the whole race to do so. To the inside. Oh, he might have given him a little bit of bump there. No runoff, though. CPAC coming around. Three laps to go. Kylie Grider, huge send in that turn, trying to get everything she can. Loses some time off the straightaway. Yeah, she's sending in deep in every turn, maybe trying to hope to get to the back bumper so she can move him one of these times. Grider is known to be an aggressive racer, and she's not afraid to move someone if she has to. Down the back stretch, CPAC looking in his mirror, seeing not really anyone there. But I bet when he enters the turn, it gets a lot more scary. One lap to go for C-Packet. C-Packet has led every lap this race, putting on an absolute clinic here. Going into turns 3 and 4 for the final time. It looks like C-Packet will hold on to it. C-Packet, he will do the double, maybe even the triple, but tonight he wins part number 1. C-Packet goes to victory lane. Great race by him, led every single lap. He's coming around for his burnout. Oh, and he smokes the tires. He's coming around for his burnout. Everybody else will file on the pit road and go home. CPAC, it came a little too hot for his burnout. I wouldn't destroy this car too much, CPAC. Whoa. There you go. Because you might have to use this thing again for a track like Langley or Lanier. He's burned it down. What a race. He's burning it down on the back stretch and not the front stretch because all the stands are back here. And there's just a lot more room. This is Seed Packet's first career win. Even though it is just an exhibition, he still won it. And he ought to be happy about it. Smoke show here on the backstretch. You can't even see the truck. You cannot even see the truck. There it is. Look at him. Oh. Oh, he's going to do a line burnout. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at him keeping that car straight. Oh, into the tires. And that's going to be the end of his burnout and the end of this coverage. Thank you for watching. And I beg you to keep watching my races. Thanks for watching.